All right, all you ribbon microphone fans out there, I have a ribbon mic hack for you today, so stay tuned. You do not want to miss this episode. All right, I have in front of me today a RCA KB-2B. There's three versions of this. There's the KB-2A, which is a low impedance, the KB-2B, which is high impedance, 30,000 ohms, and the KB-2C, which is a low impedance with a chrome body. What I've done to it is I discovered a transformer that will fit right in there. It's made by a company called FAB in England, and it is a great transformer. I'm talking in this thing right now after it's been modified, so I'm going to show you briefly what I did to modify this, do a little bit of sound testing between this and the KB-2C, which is RCA's transformer. So stay tuned.
Anyway, high impedance version, so it's not even really utilizing the XLR connector. It's only got wires hooked to pins 1 and 2. 3 is left blank. And kind of useless, because most preamps are 150 ohms. This is would be good for like plugging into a PA type amp. I'm not sure really what it'd be good for. So I want to try to see if there's enough room in this thing to put a low impedance transformer, since it's useless anyway. To get these things apart, I had to pop off the RCA logos. Be gentle with that. There's a couple springs in there that need to come out. Here's another one. They are tricky to change the ribbon. It's hard because you got to go through all this. Pull out both of these like so. Kind of a difficult mic. It's a quirky little thing. So if you find one in good shape, you want to look for one that doesn't have any corrosion. It has all the parts, and all the parts need to look like they've been there since original. If they say it doesn't work because there's, you know, on an audio, don't worry about that. You can fix all the audio parts, at least I can. But the parts you need to look out for are the make sure all the cosmetic parts are there. This little band, impossible to make. It's a stamping or and it's chrome plated. To make that would cost more than the mic's worth. So you pull this straight up once you get released, and then you can get to the screws that hold the grill on. And those are a 256 brass screw, so be careful. Don't tighten them up too tight when you go to put it back together. And this has the magnets as the pull pieces, for the ribbon to go on. There's your grill. Don't let anything happen to that.
Yeah. See right there? You can see it sagging.
There it is, the outer shell.
Looky there. A loud FAB transformer.
And it's physically the same size. I see no difference. So I think we got lucky. Yeah, this is going to be awesome because this is a very good transformer. It's the FAB XL, which stands for extra loud. That's going in there. This baby is going to be my personal mic, I think. I may sell it if I get enough money out of it. But it's, this transformer is about, I don't know, $80 or so. So, we'll see if I can get this installed. Sorry, I think I got it. It was a tight fit. But there's a slight angle. You also have to notice how this angles back. You want to put the front of the mic. There is kind of a front and back, even though it should sound pretty close the same. The front has the nuts holding the ribbon in, and the back has the screws heads. Also has the solder so it's not as clean a taper leading into the vocals. At least that's what I'm making the front as. Got enough wire sticking out. I had to run a new wire. This one's still short, but that's the original wire. Whoop. Check it. Look at there. A lot skinnier than 44.
All right, that's pretty much what I did to modify this thing. I've tried all kinds of different transformers with microphones in the past. The Veracoustic, you can also make those hot sounding by using the same type of transformer. I've tried all the brands of transformers. This seems to be the best. It's got a really nice hot output. It's the FAB microphone company, and you can find them on www.fabmicrophones.com. That's F-A-B. These microphone transformers are made in England. They use 80% nickel laminations, so it's a very efficient transformer. And I'm just very, very pleased that these transformers were identical in size to the original RCA. So very tight fit to get that in there. Even the original RCA, they made it in the 50s, and they were commenting on how they made it microscopic transformer that would fit in this microphone. So we got the exact replacement from FAB, and the model on that is the XL, which stands for extra loud. They also have another one that's four-digit part number. I'm not sure off the top of my head what it is, but check out their website. They have also microphones, ribbon mics for sale also. And I tell you, let me just show you what the difference is between this now and a stock RCA KB-2C. So I'm just going to go ahead and unplug it now while it's live, cut out the part that gets where it mutes. All right, check 1, 2. All right, and we're back with the KB-2C, which is the low impedance. It's set to 250 ohms. Same settings on the mic preamp. So identical settings. Same distance away. I don't think I dropped the mic stand much. If not, this is point blank, about 8 inches away. These are actually close proximity mics, they say, so you want to talk close, but I found unless you put a popper stopper in front of it like this, you're going to have issues with P-popping. This has a 1.2 micron ribbon in it, so it's very thin ribbon. The other one we just tested has a 2.5 micron ribbon, which is the standard RCA ribbon. Actually, yeah, it is new old stock ribbon in the old one. This is another company that makes this ribbon material. But I wanted to try, this has such kind of a low output. I wanted to try a thinner ribbon to try to boost the output. But I may just convert this one also to a FAB microphone transformer. So let me switch back again to the FAB transformer. Okay, and I'm back now with the, let me tighten everything up, with the FAB transformer KB2, we're going to call this KB2X, call it for experimental. I'm going to unplug the power adapter for the MacBook Pro because it'll buzz if I do this and I don't unplug the power charger for some reason. This is the voice music switch. This is in music, which is your full spectrum of sound, all your low frequencies, and this is your voice. So this knocks off the bottom end around 100 hertz and below, and then so it's kind of tinny sounding. A lot of people use this for hi-hats, things like that. But this microphone is actually a good vocal mic. You just have to remember to put this in front of it for popper stopper, and it's a close proximity. I'm right now, I have to probably turn down the volume a little bit, but no, I guess not. I'm about 2 to 3 inches away right now, but this really helps if I put this in front of it. So it's a great close proximity mic. Even if you get back here, it doesn't really start to thin out that much, especially if you go to music. I usually just record all my stuff in music setting. If it's too much bass, then you can roll that filter off with your in the post production. So here's with the music switch engaged at a close proximity. I'm about 2.5-3 inches away from the ribbon. It may be a little too loud. Yes, it is too loud. I could turn it down. So turn it down just a little bit for close proximity, and it gets your voice a little deeper. And turn it back up, and you can stand back here. Since it's a velocity mic, the background is going to matter what it sounds like. So you can curve this little flipper thing up and down. That's why they call it the paintbrush. It looks like a paintbrush, and you can reflect off of different items to get your different sounds. Put some acoustic foam back there. So it's a pretty versatile microphone. These things are very underrated. You should probably pick one up if you can for the right price. And if you don't want to do it yourself, send it to me. I can put the transformer in for you. But I definitely highly recommend these extra loud FAB brand transformers made in England. You can find them at the www.fabmicrophones.com, and definitely worth every penny. These things sound excellent, as you can tell. Also got a chart here. I'm going to show you the difference between them. I just hooked them up. I know you probably can't tell, but here is I ran a frequency sweep on both the music and voice. So here this is. It's you can see in the green is the FAB microphone with the music setting. Has the most bass. Looks kind of flat, but it's exactly the same curve as the RCA transformer. So other than it's just a little bit lower on output. I'm trying to see like 80, is it 85, 80, or 80, 90. You're looking at about 5 dB of difference between this and the RCA transformer. And the RCA transformer was pretty hot. So definitely worth the money. You could even put this in the KB-2C if you want to hot rod it, make it sound better. But definitely a upgrade to the high impedance. That's kind of useless. A lot of people have these high impedance laying around. They try adapters and everything else, but the problem with a high impedance, it's going to have that hiss in the background because it's not matched to your preamp. Unless you can find a high impedance preamp that's quote professional, but it's two conductors generally. It's, even though it's an XLR connector, there's only pin number one, which is shield, and pin number two is the only two that are hooked up. Well, this has your hot, low, and your shield hooked up, all three of them. So anyway, I thought you might enjoy this little hack that I discovered on a RCA KB-2B, or in this case, I'm going to call this the KB-2X for experimental. So this will be in my inventory for sale, although I'm going to probably use it for micing up some of my next projects, which I have. The next step, I always like to tell you what's coming up next, is going to be this. I'm going to turn this Mark Martin hard body plastic model snap tight kit into a 1/24th scale slot car. So you want to tune in for that. Like I say, I got a variety of genres on my YouTube channel. You probably won't find another channel like this, so don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and stay tuned for the next episode.